The camp is in a hilly area covered in thorny bushes and refuse. A quarter of the camp is underwater. Among the tents and cardboard and tarpaulin shelters is a church made of bits of plastic and wood. This is life in the jungle, the name given to this disused dump just 5 kilometers from Calais town centre. Around 4,000 refugees and migrants live here in appalling conditions. They have fled from Afghanistan, Syria, Eritrea or Sudan. Some have been here for months. While a few wait to get official documents, most go back and forth as they risk their lives attempting to cross to England. This young man from Sudan, who arrived here last week, explains.
People, they are broken, they are leg, they are injured. Some of them, they die because of a train. They don't know how to go there. That one, I'm afraid, how can I pass there? If the police arrest me, maybe even they took me to Sudan, that I'm afraid.
Living conditions are very harsh and violence is rife in the camp. On the 10th of September, a Médecins Sans Frontières team started working with Doctors of the World who have been running a clinic since June.
It's going to be winter soon. We're seeing lots of respiratory infections, but there will be more and more, and lots of scabies because of lack of hygiene and overcrowding in the camp. There are injuries due to violence too, which is common here, disputes amongst themselves or with, let's say, the authorities.
Sanitation is a disaster too. Opened by the French government last January to assemble in one place the refugees and migrants who had been gathering in the town, the camp has only 30 toilets and just 3 water points installed. The 3 refuse containers are not enough, and there's no rubbish collection. A logistics team has launched a vast clean-up campaign.
We've got a team handling sanitation in the camp, and they're setting up a waste management system. This requires informing communities and organizing a daily refuse collection. Waste management is a real problem in the camp.
Several associations and many volunteers do what they can to help, because here in Calais, France is in breach of its obligation to provide protection.